following is a special presentation of ABC Sports.
Pizza Hut, college basketball on ABC Sports. Today we're in Baltimore, Maryland at the arena as the Terrapins of Maryland take on the fifth-ranked Minutemen of the University of Massachusetts. We'll be back with the tip-off next.
College basketball brought to you by Pizza Hut, where great food and fun times bring people together. Buick and your local dealers. Remember Buick, the new symbol for quality in America. The new Gillette Sensor XL with microfins that set up your beard for the world's best shave. And Dean Witter, there are many ways to measure success. Dean Witter measures success one investor at a time.
And welcome back to the Baltimore Arena, where today Massachusetts looks for some revenge against the University of Maryland. Hi, everybody. Along with Dick Vitale, I'm Roger Twybell. Coming back off that big loss in the NCAA Regional, Massachusetts looking to bounce back against Maryland. Keys to the game today, Dick. What do you look at?
Well, number one, for Massachusetts, they better be able to handle the pressure of Maryland, the trapping defenses. That puts a burden on the little guard, Kellogg. On the other side, rebounding power. They've been able to neutralize Massachusetts, Maryland on the offensive glass as we look at the lineup.
And Lou Rowe, you notice at center, not Marcus Camby. Camby will play today, but he's been battling the flu, so they go small. Meanwhile, Maryland solid. Boothip, Smith, Rhodes, and Simpkins. And Dick, tell me about Lou Rowe.
Lewis Rowe, a dominant player on the inside, has been brilliant and scintillating early in the season. He's been scoring big. He'll hook up, though, on a defensive end. He will check, jamming Joe Smith, the diaper dandy of the year last year. Roger, I'm so excited. I can't wait to see these two guys hook up. Williams, Calipari, what a way to kick off our season.
He's ready, folks, and so are we. Maryland and Massachusetts, nothing but strangers. Last season, Maryland and UMass, 94-80. UMass gets the first win. Lou Rowe, 30 points and 8 rebounds. But Dick, more important than that, out in Wichita, Kansas, second round of the NCAA, 95-87. Maryland shot 70% in the second half of that game.
Well, Massachusetts was playing brilliant basketball until the 9-minute mark. They were up 9. And then all of a sudden, the 3-point shot went down. And Gary, who's a superstar now, they just gave him a 7-year extension. In fact, I got a little tidbit for you. Not only is it 7 years on the last year, Roger, maybe you and I could get a contract like this. He gets an extra 3 years and they make it 10 years. Unbelievable, but he deserves it. He's been a solid coach on a collegiate level.
This game being played in Baltimore, not at Cole Fieldhouse on the campus of the University of Maryland, because Gary Williams really is trying to establish Maryland as the state university, and they've been trying to play one game here every year.
Gary also likes the idea in the city of Baltimore. There's some great high school players, specifically usually at Dunbar High School. John Calipari says, our program has arrived. He said, you know why I knew it arrived? I was watching TV the other night, and Maryland's playing, and their crowd starts chanting, we want Mass, we want Mass. He said, I never thought that that would happen, that an ACC school would want us from Massachusetts. Slow me down, Roger. I'm all pumped up. Slow me down.
You're gonna slow down. Massachusetts in the red, dark jerseys, Maryland in the white. We are underway from Baltimore. That is Kellogg, 14. Bingle is 3. Padilla gets a start over Mike Williams, who's been playing a key role off the bench for John Calipari.
He'll play a lot of minutes. When you can come in with a Michael Williams and a Marcus Camby, they're certainly both starters on any level. Man-to-man defense by Maryland.
Lou Rowe down low, the right-handed leaner, won't go, the rebound. Joe Smith loses it. Dingle's there to put it up and in.
Daniel Dingle's one of those kids that really scraps, hustles, good defensive player.
Quickly at the other end. spins out, his hip is fouled.
Etri Hick has really been playing outstanding basketball. He's a very confident athlete. He runs the court exceptionally well. Excellent transition player.
Foul was on Dante Bright, number four.
Dante Bright, interesting matchup. Dante Bright and Keith Booth are first cousins, and they both played on that famed Dunbar High School team that went undefeated along with Michael Lloyd.
Yep, 65% from the free throw line this year. And in and out, no good. Maryland has gotten off, Dick, to a 6-1 start. UMass just 2-1, but Maryland really only challenged in the game against Utah and Arizona State over the Maui Invitational.
Well, if they win this game, they could be 12-1. Don't tell Gary that going into North Carolina. They have, after this game, teams like, for example, Towson State, American U.
Pressure there by Maryland quickly. Here comes UMass. Kellogg, the pull-up pop on top, and he hits it.
One of the real under-heralded players in basketball, in that he's a steady player. He's not a spectacular player. And they're trying right now. The game plan for Massachusetts is to attack the double team and attack the pressure.
And Kellogg with a steal. So after he made the jumper, brings it down to the other end. Can't get it to go.
Made a bad decision.
Comes away with it.
Made a bad decision right there. Should have given a little bounce pass to Padilla for the layup.
Foul was on Dingle.
The one thing you know when you play Maryland, you're going to face double team traps all over the court. He utilizes the full court, Gary Williams.
Nick, how do they match up physically with Camby being under the weather with a flu?
Well, that really hurts because they've become such a small lineup right now, and Booth is so powerful and physically tough at the wing position.
That's Rhodes 15. Booth with the quick step, and they call it on.
Massachusetts would like the game to be a little bit more 5-on-5. They'll use up tempo. They'll run. Look at us right now playing each other in a post here. I mean, there is, look at that great post position. Joe Smith is such a dominant inside player. He's got great touch and quickness.
Padilla getting a lot of action for UMass. Number 12, Edgar Padilla.
He's a combination guard. They get good spacing, try to run the motion game.
Kellogg turns it over. Hip took it, gets it to Rhodes, the left-handed in.
Strong left-handed player, Johnny Rhodes. Johnny takes it home, baby.
Rhodes averaging over 15 points per game and almost six rebounds. Can you get six rebounds out of your off guard, Dick? That's really something.
Yeah, he's a solid rebounder from the guard slot. He's almost like a wing player. Good man-to-man defense right now by Maryland. Trying to put pressure on the ball, give some help.
Rhodes in the paint. Dingle keeps it alive, knocks it out of bounds. We're just underway from the Baltimore Arena. Massachusetts leads Maryland 4-3.
Massachusetts has to get a little bit more balance offensively. They can't become one-dimensional and want to just drive the ball into Lou Rowe.
Simpkins, number 10, runs the show. Inside the turnaround shot, and right there for Johnny Rhodes.
Johnny Rhodes is very strong physically from the guard slot. He and Simpkins really play well together. There's that look at the trap. They really hurt Mass with a 2-on-2 half-court trap in the NCAA tournament.
Right in the lane, off the glass, Smith battling. Dingle had it momentarily, then he lost it as Maryland brings it down the other way.
Massachusetts is going to really need Marcus Camby. They can't win this game today without Camby to give him size and shot blocking on the inside to neutralize the great athletic ability of Maryland.
Simpkins drops it back to Smith. Big push there, offensive foul on Joe Smith, who's bulked up as Camby gets ready to check in. But I was going to say, Smith has really bulked up this year, put on about 20 pounds.
He's got such a great touch, great attitude. Here comes Marcus Camby, only averaging 8 points a game, was 1-for-7 against that good Kansas defense. He has to become a little bit more active offensively. Had a big game last year against Maryland, 32 points, and I believe
10 rebounds, 10 three block shots in that game. You know, he was only the fifth freshman to block over 100 shots in a season. As I tell you, these two teams are battling on the floor, and the basketball will go to Maryland.
Michael Williams is a clutch player. He's won 5 games late in the game. There goes the ball. Now watch the deck. Here comes Maryland. They're going to dive. They're going to scrap. They're going to get on the floor. There's Joe Smith, the superstar. He says, I need to get on the floor. And that becomes contagious when you see a star hustling and scrapping.
Rhodes.
Camby now matched up on Smith.
Smith for three. There it goes.
Smith trying to take Camby away from the basket. as you mentioned, a tremendous shot blocker.
Williams in the game now, number 10. He's played a vital role off the bench.
He's a big-time guard, Roger. He loves the big games. He likes the camera. He was great last year against North Carolina when they beat Carolina in the NIT. See, I'd go to Camby a little bit against him. He'd be a little bit weak, though. He had the flu. Blue Rowe uses that powerful body off the glass, trying to follow.
And here comes X-Ree.
Yep.
Trying to bring it down himself. Williams knocks it loose, and it'll go over to Massachusetts. That's four turnovers for Maryland.
A little bit out of control right there, X-Ree hit. They're so keyed up. John Calipari's done one of the great rebuilding jobs in America. Remember, they used to play teams like New Hampshire and Vermont, and here they are challenging all the big boys.
There you see the turnovers. Maryland four, Massachusetts with two. I'll tell you what, before Calipari got there, 10 consecutive losing seasons for the University of Massachusetts since then, five times in the postseason, and they've won 67% of their games.
Incredible, and played against good competition, especially in this pre-conference schedule. And Atlantic 10 is not easy with Temple and George Washington and West Virginia and company. And St. Joseph's is very good this year.
Kellogg, not spectacular, takes good care of the basketball in his career. Assist turnover ratio about 2-1.
Yeah, understands his role. Knows what his role is to distribute, to get everyone else involved. This guy can score.
There's Camden. Air ball. Rose got it. And traffic.
I would take Lou Rowe out for about a minute. He is trying so hard, and he's so tough and tenacious. Sometimes you got to settle him down, and then bring him back on the floor.
15:42 to go first half, and Maryland leads it by a point.
It may be December, but the action is hot. The Chiefs and the Dolphins give it all they got.
Last five games, Maryland against Colgate, Maryland, Baltimore County, Bucknell. They scored over 100 in all those games. Loyola of Maryland, and then the lost Arizona State. This is what they've done. Hip average in 20, and good numbers by all those players.
Yeah, they got really a lot of balance, but you got to remember this. They out-personneled all those clubs. If we look at the field goal percentage, Massachusetts a little bit tight, starting out, trying to hustle and scrap, but trying to force the action. Lou Rowe's got to settle down a little bit and let the shot come to him rather than him try to force the shot.
5-4, Maryland leads.
Hello! Hello!
Throwing it down inside for Maryland is Joe Smith.
Well, they utilize the great diagonal pass. They attack the pressure. Massachusetts tries to answer Maryland by trapping, and Maryland has the answer. They go right up the court diagonally for the lob.
Williams for three.
Big-time player. Michael Williams, suspended academically, didn't play against Arkansas, but he really is a special player and a key player from Massachusetts.
He's a senior out of Hartford, Connecticut. Booth, the spin move, gets it on the baseline and hit, misses the slam. And it'll be Massachusetts basketball.
Get Barbaro with that ball. You know, those numbers you showed with the great balance that Maryland has. You watch the diagonal pass now. This little guy can pass the rock. He dishes it and up and away. Joe Smith just finishes it off. Allowed to grab the rim to protect himself.
Down to Bright is checked back into the game, number four.
Oh, there's a bump. Can't hand check him, can't bump him, no doubt. You know, Roger, getting back to those numbers, a lot of balance and a lot of scoring, but they out-personnel those people. That's beating a lot of teams that really can't play with Maryland. The true test will be when they get into the ACC.
I wanted to ask you, Dick, they've taken different approaches, these two teams, to their early season schedule. UMass has gone up against Arkansas. They've gone up against Kansas. They've had a game against Pitt, and now they play Maryland.
Well, you know, that certainly gets you ready for the season, but the Atlantic 10 this year will not be as supreme and as super as the ACC.
Rhodes will bring it down, drops it back to Simpkins. As Booth gets the rebound, good pass inside the hip. Camby comes in to snare it.
Simpkins shot 43% from three-point range, so he can make that shot.
Kellogg inside the row, finally gets one to go.
He's got great hands, and he's a tough back-to-the-basket player.
26.7 points a game, almost 12 rebounds a contest for Lou Rowe.
Man-to-man defense.
Smith has it stripped by Rowe, but they're going to call the foul.
Can't allow the ball to get in that deep to Joe Smith. What an interesting story. Murray High School, Norfolk, Virginia. Wasn't one of your blue chip top 10 players in America. but certainly was recruited people this evening. Look at the upcoming schedule. Houston State, Morgan State, LaSalle, American, and then they're home with Georgia and at North Carolina. If they win this game, they could be 12-1.
Going into that game at Carolina.
Yeah, Georgia Tech will be tough, certainly, but they're playing them at home, and at home, they're going to be tough to beat this year, Maryland.
Smith, 78% from the free throw line. He's been to the line more than any other Maryland player now, 48 times this year.
He's a combination player in terms of an inside post player, as well as a guy that can step out and face the basket. I'll tell you one thing, they got all kinds of scouts here today, evaluating all kinds of media people
here.
Who
does he remind you?
Well, some people say Keith Lee, the guy who used to star at Memphis State. I think he's a little stronger than Keith.
After the miss, Rowe the rebound. Williams will bring it down.
Michael Williams can't create his own shot. They run a little passing game, which simply means pass, go away.
Nice pass by Rowe to Dingle. Stripped away. Good job defensively by Maryland. I'll tell you, they're a prolific team at stealing the basketball. Led the ACC a year ago in that category with almost 10 a game, averaging over 11 steals a game this year.
Well, Johnny Rhodes only needs three more steals to break the all-time record at the school. Roger, I'll tell you, it's always special to be at games such as this. You can feel the NCAA kind of feeling, the excitement, the electricity. Got even Calvin Ripken here today. I was talking to him, the baseball player. He's well-rested.
Mario Lucas has checked into the game as traveling called outside. Lucas, their sixth man, very efficient. Doesn't get that many minutes, but while he's in there, he makes things happen for him.
Well, he can shoot the basketball. They would like to see him rebound a little bit more and play better on a defensive end.
Lucas is 21.
There's that spacing out of their passing game, 15 feet apart. Pass, usually go away. You watch when a guy makes a pass or cut and go away from the ball.
Padilla from outside.
Edgar Padilla and Kellogg. Certainly not spectacular, but steady. And Padilla can play the one position, a point guard or the second guard.
Lucas misses the long-range shot.
And oh, nobody got back.
No call there as Rhodes picks it up. Simpkins now down to the baseline and a foul down there.
You can hear the contact from up here. There should have been a layup right there for Massachusetts. Dante Bright was all alone after the miss by Lucas. Maryland, the one thing that impressed me yesterday watching them practice, and I know it impressed you, is the fact they seem to love to play together. They have such tremendous feeling for each other.
See Kellogg and players sitting down as Lucas goes to the line. The practice, of course, yesterday, Dick, and then they had the game on Thursday night against Colgate, even though they ran away with that victory over O'Donnell Foyle.
Yeah, Donald Foyle certainly putting on some nice numbers this year, but they're 0-6. But they'll do better when they get into the league. They've lost to some real tough teams in their pre-conference schedule. Syracuse, Maryland, Mississippi State.
Lucas, 75% free throw shooter, misses them both.
Oh, you got him right now, Williams.
Baseline pull-up off and hits. Johnson Bright. He's got his first two.
Dante Bright was a tremendous high school player, was top five in the United States. Had a sit out 2 years ago, top 48. I hate that label, they should wipe that out.
UMass right now on a 10-1 run. Tell me about this style right here.
Oh, well, that's Williams. That's incredible. That's why Bobby Knight told me. You know, Bobby Knight said, you know, the 90s might not be for me. He said, baggy shorts, black socks, three-point shots. I said, Bob, but the bottom line is you'll still win your 20 games. But it's amazing how things have changed drastically here in the 90s.
Hey,
the cosmetic end of it.
These guys from UMass got to watch it. Those pants are freaking way down. Lucas off the glass and count it.
Nice post move by Lucas down in the box. And that's what Gary Williams is searching for. He wants to find some positive minutes from people off that bench. This hit with a good wing pass, a good entry, and now the good drop step, good post move. They work on it on the inside. You know, Gary Williams almost, had he had known that the probation was going to be so severe, he would have stayed at Ohio State initially because he had no idea that it was going to include 2 years, no TV, 2 years, no NCAA tournament. He's back at his alma mater, and now he's happy the way it's turned out, but it was a struggle in the early years.
Pressure right there by Maryland. You know, Lucas has now come into the game. He's got 3 points, but this is the thing. He's averaging about 13 and a half minutes per game this year, averaging 7.5 points and nearly 4 rebounds a contest. That's efficient use for the time that he's in there.
Yeah, but again, remember the scores, or remember who they played. Those are blowouts. He has to do it in the ACC.
Camby!
Well, Camby's got good touch. He can run the court. He's 6'11". He can block shots. He has to develop a little bit more of a hungry attitude in wanting to be a player and really push himself a la Lou Rowe. He's got great, great work there.
16-11, 5-point lead for UMass. 12:04 to go. First half from the Baltimore Arena.
They're doing a good job keeping the ball away from Joe Smith. Lou Rowe checking him on the inside. Lou Rowe's a great defensive player as well as a solid offensive player.
Booth off the glass, doesn't find the rim. Loose ball picked up by Smith, but out of bounds.
What a tremendous job inside by Lou Rowe. Ball you man theory, beating him to the spot.
Its claim to the national title when they battle Pac-10 champ Oregon. It's the granddaddy of them all, the Rose Bowl, January 2nd on ABC.
Roger, we're going to see the defensive concepts of Massachusetts. Watch number 15 right here, Lou Rowe. See how he's aware of the ball in his man? He's aware of number 32, but there's the help from Marcus Camby. He alters shots. He doesn't only block shots, he alters them, and that's a special dimension to have to a team.
Lou Rowe so far shooting just 1 of 4 with 2 points, but nonetheless, Massachusetts with a 5-point lead.
But you know what I like about Lou Rowe? Struggling offensively, but he's doing it on a defensive end. Well, here's that 2-1-2 press. That was the difference in the NCAA tournament. There's the trap. You got to swing it to the side and then dump it inside. That's the way you want to break it. That's a clinic. That is a clinic. You could see Massachusetts went to the classroom, and they worked on attacking the 2-1-2. Bring it to the sideline, to the middle, and the dump down. Wow, that excites me.
I know it. Especially after the timeout. They come back out and are able to execute like that. Well done. And Massachusetts now with a 7-point lead, their biggest lead. And look at Camby bringing it down the floor. Will he take it all the way? And he draws the foul.
Marcus Camby takes the ball to the goal and gets fouled. But a real, real heady play would have been to give the ball back to the middle and then cut without the basketball and jam it.
Now, Camby was on intravenous fluids, played briefly the other night, really struggling with the flu this week, came over to the table before the game, and are you going to play? Yeah, I'm here. I'm going to play.
Yeah, he wants to play. He's certainly a kid that has to get in the weight room a little bit more, get a little bit stronger. He's got tremendous potential. His upside's incredible. John Calipari, as you mentioned, 3 NCAA tournaments in a row. Last year, beaten by Maryland. 2 years ago, they got beat by Kentucky in 92. They were 30-5, had a tremendous season. In fact, that was the year that Kentucky lost that heartbreak to Christian Leitner style down there in Philly.
Beautiful move by Simpkins. Won't go down as Dingle gets the rebound. And here comes Kellogg.
Different so far is Massachusetts neutralizing Joe Smith, not allowing him to get active offensively inside.
Traveling called on Dingle.
Take a look right now against the 2-1-2. You bring the ball right to the high post, into the gut of that, and the dump down, and there's the conversion in the layup. So it went to the sideline, to the high post, down inside. That is a coach's dream.
They go to Smith, the left-handed in.
Got to keep the ball away from him. And too many good things happen if he touches the rock on the interior.
20-13, still a 7-point lead.
He's so quick for a big player.
Camby from outside, does he have the range? Yes.
I think he likes Maryland. He was sick. I'll tell you, Roger, I was telling some of the writers, that means he's going to have a big, big night.
He's got 6. And whether it's a big night or a big day, he has played well in the past. As Rhodes takes it from outside and it won't go. Smith can't get the offensive follow. One more time, and finally Rhodes comes in to get it.
Johnny Rhodes, a solid rebounder, 6 rebounds a game from the guard slot. Massachusetts' strength is offensive rebounding, 63 to their opponent's 33 early this year.
Tingle inside. You saw Rowe was double-teamed right there.
When we talk about the great front-court players in America, number 32 is right there near the head of the class. There's the little kiss off the glass. And on the other side, you stay in the eastern United States, you hear about Marcus Camby. There's Camby showing he can shoot the jump shot as well. Nothing but nylon, SBN. Look at the emotion.
Number 50's checked into the game for UMass. Freshman Enos Norville from Fayetteville, North Carolina, and Hargrave Military Academy. They're very put active. Up some big numbers, 18 points, 12 rebounds, 3 blocks a game.
A very active player. In fact, the coach at Hargrave was a former player under John Calipari at Massachusetts, so that helped them getting him a coach by the name of Coach Burns. He has a fine young assistant, Coach George Blaney's son.
After Dingle missed the second one, traveling called, and the basketball will go to Maryland, 22-15.
I think it's great to see so many of these big matchups earlier in the season.
I agree with you.
I think it's fantastic. I think coaches are more secure in their jobs, number one. Number two, TV obviously makes the matchup. And number three, coaches don't fear a loss early in the season. It's not like football where it's disastrous.
Does that mean Georgetown's going to change the schedule?
Georgetown has changed it.
Yeah, they have.
Joe Smith with the drive. Georgetown has played Arkansas. They got Memphis tonight. And Allen Iverson is for real. He is genuine. He's an instant hit. Solid goal.
Smith now has 8. Dingle trapped in the lane. Puts it up. Hey, when in doubt, shoot it.
David Dingle out of New York City. Went to St. Raymond's.
24-17, we're at the Baltimore Arena, sold out here. As every year, Jerry Williams tries to play one game. Last year they had Towson State, a couple years ago, Oklahoma. The miss, and Padilla will bring it down. He's got Dingle in front with Rowe on the wing, pull up by Rowe.
I thought he should have kicked the ball out to Dingle to the left-handed side. Dingle's a left-handed player. Look at the intensity. Look at the intensity of this guy.
And speaking of some intensity, how about Arnold Palmer, Jack Nicklaus, PGA Senior Tour, the regular tour, the LPGA. First ever Diners Club matches. That's coming up next here on ABC Sports. Nicklaus and Palmer taking on Jim Dent and Chichi Rodriguez.
Hey, Roger, you're a big golf guy. Can you introduce me one time to Arnold Palmer?
No problem.
You think you could?
The king.
Will I get a chance to meet him?
You can meet him.
I played tennis one time with Jack Nicklaus. I was so in awe. It was incredible. He had me at his house playing tennis. I couldn't believe it.
8:45 to go, first half.
Camby played up on a high post with a curl move.
Padilla for 3. Hits!
I'll tell you, their guards are solid. They don't get a lot of recognition. They play certainly in the shadow of their great baseline, but their guards do a steady job.
Smith in the lane. Block right there by Camby.
No, you're going to
call
it
goaltending.
Definitely. Trail official right with the ball. Stan Rhode, excellent ball. Joe Smith uses either hand. There's the kickoff to the wing. Look at him facing the basket. He's going to be a tremendous foreman. And there is the drive down the lane.
Hey, Dick, you knew he was going to be good in his college debut. He laid 26 on Othello Harrington, huh?
Yeah, they really beat Georgetown in a real tough battle, a one-point game. Othello, by the way, is going to get involved more offensively, and he will. John's changed his philosophy with Georgetown, but Othello's too talented not to touch the ball.
Smith's got 9 points, 6 in the last minute. Is right on the pull-up from the side. Won't go, and the rebound pulled down by Maryland. Simpkins drops it off inside, and the whistle and the foul.
There is really something special about having a guard that could break down the defense and create opportunities. Wayne Simpkins did that in that situation. John Calipari not happy. His assistant coach, James Flint.
He learned this move from you, Dick.
Oh, look at Calipari. Look, he wants to be a referee. Look at him calling a charge. Get the zebra shirt on him. Oh, he's suave. He has got the Armani special. A little cocky, a little brash. But all coaches have to have that little cockiness about them.
Johnny Rhodes from the line, and Rhodes with 7 points now.
But the only thing different, he and I, he's so good-looking, and I'm so ugly. It's unbelievable. Look how good-looking he is.
Here we go. And he's got a lot more hair than you, too. That's obvious, right? That's the understatement of the year. As Rhodes missed the second.
I thought you were going to be nice to me. You bought me this beautiful tie I'm wearing here today. I want to thank you for that beautiful gift.
27-20. 7-point lead for UMass with under 8 minutes to go. First half, Williams for 3. Lucas comes down with a rebound.
Not a good shot in that possession. You want to make the extra pass, get people involved. Maryland really running that ball up the court.
Rhodes has that 3-point attempt blocked. Looks like Dante Bright got down there to block it. It's Williams off the glass, won't go. And Lucas with 1 more rebound.
He was indecisive in shooting that ball. He was thinking of making a pass to Bright on the wing.
Simpkins over on the wing. Wayne Bristol, who's checked into the game now, loses the ball. Bristol, one of the co-captains, number 31, a senior from Beltsville,
They look for scoring out of Bristol. When he comes in, he's a shooter.
Foul was on Norville.
Maryland really having a little tough time getting a kind of rhythm they'd like offensively. Trying to make the first phase happen out of their transition game.
And Kavarik now checks into the game for Maryland. And well, Kavarik, the sophomore from Greensboro, North Carolina.
They're looking for some minutes out of him to handle the basketball, run the club, get the ball to key players on the floor. You know, he's really been quiet. The two guys probably feeling the pressure of playing here at home. Booth is certainly bright. They haven't been able to really play to the level that they're capable of playing. Remember, they're both from Dunbar High School. He has done the most amazing job in rebuilding a program.
Booth and Rowe being talked to underneath the basket as Bristol makes the first one. He is 8 out of 9 on the year from the free throw line. You know, Bristol, how about this, his career high, Dick, against number one ranked North Carolina. He had 14.
North Carolina had him against Villanova the other day, made all the big plays down the stretch. Certainly got one of the dominant big players in America, Rasheed Wallace. On the other hand, Dick Paparis says, no talking, guys, play basketball.
Is there such a thing, Dick, as a sophomore slump? Joe Smith had a great freshman year.
When you're great, there's no slumps. Yeah. If you can't play, there are slumps. And you think about sophomore jinxes. The thing I like about him here, he goes into triple threat position. He takes the ball into traffic. He's twisted and hanging and twisted, and he gets the rock off in traffic. He can make the play facing. Gary doesn't like to see him sitting on the sideline. He doesn't want him to be a member of his all-pine team, and he doesn't need an assistant coach. But he's got to get him a little rest.
Hey, Dick, the only the third freshman to make first-team Atlantic Coast Conference. You know who the other two are?
No, help me out. Trivia.
Mark Price, Skip Wise.
Wow. Uh-huh. But it's some real
like Camby. Look at him.
He's a man possessed,
yep,
right there. Great offensive rebound, and that's one of their strengths. 63 coming in here to their opponent's only 33. That's like almost 2-1.
Camby with 8 points and 3 rebounds, and you got to keep in mind, folks, he has been battling the flu. He has been under the weather. And he has been playing awfully well since he came in. As a foul on Williams out front.
It's hard for me to believe that this guy can play in a game and go 1-for-7 in a basketball game. I should watch Marcus Camby playing very quick to the basket, great size. He was 1-for-7 against that defense of Roy Williams down at Kansas. Roy does a great job year in and year out. I love his guards, Vaughn and Hass. They play so well together.
Camby averaging just 8 points on the year. He's got that many already as Bristol will shoot the 1-and-1. Good free throw shooter. He's been with Gary Williams for 4 years. Through the hard times and now the good times again.
He can really stroke the free throw. He's got excellent touch. Rebounding certainly a key whenever you got two teams like this hooking up, who can get the advantage, especially the second and third attempts on the offensive board.
29-24.
Massey's done a pretty good job against the full court press. Here comes the trap. 1-2-1-1 is popping loose.
Bristol's got it in.
I just said they've been doing a really good job, but what do we see? Turnover City. Lou Rowe got very nonchalant with the basketball, and they stripped him.
3-point lead for UMass. And
oh, what a great play.
The back and count it.
What a great play. That was Bob Cousy style. Michael Williams around the back. Now, here's the steal. See, Lou Rowe gets a little nonchalant with the basketball. Most of all, he brought it down. You don't want to bring the ball down and neutralize and take away your size advantage. But they answer back the next possession, and they score. And that's a sign of a good basketball team.
Second foul on Simpkins as Williams will go to the line now. And Paparo says, count it. Get it up on the scoreboard.
Gary Williams wanted a foul a little bit earlier. Thought the contact was made prior to the release. Look at Gary. Did he dress? What a job. 89, he leaves Ohio State. He leaves Jimmy Jackson. In fact, a year later, in Jackson's second year, they went to the Final Eight Ohio State, losing to Michigan for the right to go to the Final Four.
It was the first free throw this year for Williams.
But he converts. He just come back after being suspended academically. Rhodes scoring on the inside. He's a versatile guard.
He's got 10. He's had a big game. 32-28. Just over 6 minutes to go, first half from Baltimore. They put 2,000 tickets on sale over at the University of Maryland. The kids camped out all night to get those 2,000 to come over to this game.
Oh, they really are feeling it down there, the enthusiasm and the spirit.
They sold out for the first time ever as Kellogg goes for three.
Oh, he got pumped.
Yeah, he's fouled by Simpkins, and that's going to be 3 on Simpkins.
Well, it's not only 3 on Simpkins, puts him on a line for 3 attempts. Gary Williams trying to tell Dick Vergara, I want the charge, the offensive foul.
But Dick, isn't that unbelievable? Maryland, for the first time in history, has sold out for every game this year. That's with all the great teams they've had.
Yeah, Lefty Drizel certainly had some super teams. Does this guy work on a sideline?
Yeah.
Is his heart and soul into the game? You get a feel for coaches. I really do. The passion and love they have on that sideline. They get a little wacky at times.
Yeah, they do.
And I was, I tell you, Roger, if you ever see me,
and you were the wackiest of the wackiest.
I was, but unfortunately, they didn't have TV in that era.
Kellogg started 69 straight games for Massachusetts. He has just been a rock for him. 9 points, 2.5 assists a game.
And he's a kid that received a lot of criticism on some of the talk shows back here in the Massachusetts area initially, saying that he shouldn't be in the starting lineup, but you know, he's just been a steady player.
There was another kid from Springfield, Massachusetts, came out about when he did and ended up at Georgia Tech.
Yeah, fair play. Yeah. By him, Travis Best might be the best point guard in America. Certainly one of them, he and Damon Stoudemire. Highest endings are going down at UCLA.
35-28, so UMass has got it back up on top in a hurry.
Boots got to get involved a little bit. Number 22, they got to get him involved offensively. He's too good a player, hasn't been involved.
As Boots takes it inside, he's pushed, but how about Hip? Hip's got 1 point so far in this game. Tonight on ABC, Kirstie Alley hosts a wonderful two-hour look at 40 years of magical Disney television, the first color broadcast of Mickey Mouse Club and more, with all your Disney favorites plus a special guest. Then it's a special night, time for Lois and Clark, all tonight here on ABC. Hey, Dick, who's your favorite Disney character?
Oh, wow, you gotta like Mickey. I like Mickey.
I thought Goofy would be
fine. Are you trying to send a message to me?
And he hits a free throw.
He's so point today. He's so strong physically. He gives him a special presence at that wing. He can make the open shot as well. What a program. His high school team, as we said, was undefeated. And Michael Boyd, now at Syracuse. Had his cousin, Dante Bright.
He was more highly recruited than Smith.
No, he was a big-time recruit. Marquee name.
Pressure once again by Maryland, but UMass doing a good job.
Well, they used the big guy. Just throw the ball high up to the big guy and then kick it out to the wings.
5:25 to go first half. Camby takes the baseline. Get the roll, tips his own miss up, won't go. And once again, the big man in the middle, Joe Smith, with the rebound.
John Calipari's got to be really happy with the effort and the energy being exerted by Camby here today.
Hip gets it inside, Smith, position.
He's got so many moves inside. He's a PT peer. He's a 3S man. He's super scintillating, sensational. I love him. Jamming Joe Smith. He can flat out play.
11 points for Joe Smith. And go for it, Tim.
And listen to the crowd. This place is exploding.
3-point ball game. UMass with the lead. Fans here on their feet and the reach over the top by Rhodes. And the second foul on Johnny Rhodes.
Wow, is he something special, Joe Smith? He's the real deal, baby. Keith Booth from out of Dunbar. Look at this here, the Dunbar connection. Dante Bright, Keith Booth, Rodney Elliott on a club as well. And remember the alums, Reggie Williams, who starred at Georgetown, helped them win that national title. Tyrone Bowles, Wingate. I mean,
Green Graham.
Oh, you're getting Graham. What about the James brothers? The late Reggie Lewis. He was a sixth man. What a tremendous college player he was at Northeastern, and certainly a great player with the Celtics.
Camby with the miss on the free throw, and quickly now Maryland back down to the other end. Smith looking from long range.
He's so versatile. That's what I love about Smith. He's really multi-dimensional. Can play outside as well as inside.
India out on Simpkins. Kip looks, shoots. Won't go. Booth gets the offensive board. Back out to Rhodes. Slashing it. Block
by Camby. Block by Camby.
And here comes Williams.
He's got Rhodes.
Sweet.
Oh, Rowe really showed a lot of poise. I thought he was going to try to jam and charge, but he showed poise right there, good leadership, but Camby made the play. What a shot-blocking whiz. Nothing like having a human eraser on the interior.
Smith loses it. Rhodes gets it. Camby with the block. It's a jump ball. Bechamero going to UMass.
Camby really possessed. I don't like this rule, Roger, because many a time the team that makes the great defensive play is penalized if it isn't alternate possession their way.
3:47 to go first half from Baltimore.
ABC Sports. Raycom College Basketball.
brought to you by Pizza Hut, where great food and fun times bring people together. Toyota and their full line of quality cars and trucks. Toyota, I love what you do for me. De Beers, a diamond is forever. And Visa, it's everywhere you want to be.
Roger Twible, Dick Vitale with you, the Roe and Joe show. What do you think?
Well, right now, certainly Joe Smith inside's been getting the advantage. Lou Rose had a tough time getting out of the gate, shooting the basketball. But I think you're going to see before it's all over, he'll have his 20.
Steps back, high arching shot, hits it over Camby.
He shot that right over Camby, the rainbow jump shot. He is so smooth. He is like velvet. He's got a great touch as well. He gets good deep position. Camby from outside, and it looked like Smith might have got a piece of it. Marcus has got to be careful that he doesn't try to play. I can do anything, you can do better.
Camby, his hip tried to make the pass. Camby swatted it out. Go ahead.
Sometimes guys try to play that game when they're playing against a star player from the opposing club. They see them do something great. He says, well, I can do that better than you can. And sometimes it can hurt your club.
37, 34, 3, 15. Left to go first half. Simpkins playing with three fouls.
Key player for Maryland right here with the basketball. He has to make things happen.
Pull-up. Can't go. Can't be the rebound.
Camby is very active, much more active than I've seen him in a long, long time.
His fifth forward is on the baseline. Ooh. He tries to follow the shot by Dwight. Williams takes it for three off the front of the rim. Back in, Ward goes. And they're going to call a foul on Lou Rowe.
Not a good shot by Michael Williams. He forced the last shot. Massachusetts up on the glass, but on the third attempt, Lou Rowe with the foul. You know, interesting. Gary was telling me
third foul.
Yeah, number three on Lewis. He's got to go to the sideline. Slow start today.
Well, he missed his first three, Dick, but then hit three of his last four.
Had a big game against Arkansas. He was so dominant against Corliss Williams. He's certainly one of the premier power forwards in the game.
You know, one thing about Lou Rowe, he's always played big in the big games. We mentioned against Maryland last year, the first game, 30 points, 8 rebounds. Against North Carolina, 28 points, 14 rebounds. Against Kansas earlier this year, 33 points, 10 rebounds. Big games bring out the best of him.
Well, he likes that spotlight. He likes the pressure. He likes hearing about all the guys that got all the national attention. He told me he wants to let them know that he can play with all those guys. He played on a Goodwill Games team this year.
Rhodes has been big for Maryland so far in this game. He's got 12. As Padilla will sit down.
Gary told me in 1983, he said that was his best team. Michael Adams, John Garris when he was at BC. But this team, he said, has the potential to be the best East Coast.
Maryland's cut it to one. 37-36. Norville underneath for UMass.
Nice basket by Norville. Pretty good when you can go to your bench and bring a freshman on like Norville to take Lou Rowe for a moment or two. They're a very deep team. Depth could be a factor in this game.
Kavarik back in the game. Gets it to Bristol.
Right now, I think Massachusetts can put a lot of pressure on these guards.
Smith, the turnaround shot, air ball, and Camby, his sixth rebound. As Bristol gets a piece of it and knocks it out of bounds.
As Massachusetts right now reversing the basketball. Now we're going to see the little pass by Kellogg. Right to the wing, and there's the reverse layup by Norville. That's the way you want to attack that pressure. You want some poise. See, they're using Camby as the outlet man against the pressure. Throw the ball up high, take advantage of his great size.
2:13 to go first half. 39-36, 3-point. Massachusetts lead.
Just what we expected. This is going to be a tough one right to the finish.
Camby taken away. They're going to call a foul on Booth. Keith Booth picks up his second.
Booth called for the foul on the wing on Camby. Camby came out of Hartford Public Schools. There's the reversal. They swing at the Camby. Comes out of Connecticut. In fact, mention Connecticut. I would love to see Massachusetts play Connecticut. I think it would be a natural. It would be a natural.
Padilla checks in. Camby so far, 8 points, 6 rebounds, and 3 blocks.
Coming off
a guy that was on IV with the flu all week.
Yeah, came off the bench. It's bad. John Calipari's got a message loud and clear. He'd like to play Connecticut, and he'd like to play Boston College.
And maybe he'll skip Arkansas and Kansas next year, huh?
He loves the tough clubs. He really likes that. He gives his program at the new Mullins Center. There's so much excitement at Massachusetts for hoops.
Simpkins. Maryland trailing by four. Hip with just 1 point in this game, and he averages over 17 a game as Smith takes it in and draws the foul.
Dorval will have a tough time trying to check Jammin' Joe. He'll have a tough time inside the young guy out of prep school.
Foul is on Kellogg. Hey, Dick, you know, the last time Maryland had a 20-win season, now keep in mind, they're already 6-1, but the last time they had a 20-win season, 1984 and 85, when Jeff Atkins, Adrian Branch were seniors, and the late Glenn Bias was a junior.
Well, I'll tell you one thing. You talk about programs and rebuilding programs. I mentioned John Calipari, but when I picked my old Frank Lloyd Wright teams, a great architect himself, Mr. Wright, and you picked the architects, you better think about the left-hander down in Maryland and what he did when he proclaimed Maryland the UCLA of the East.
The all Frank Lloyd Wright, the architects of college basketball.
John Thompson, 23 years ago, Georgetown was nowhere. He did a fantastic job. Lute Olson, Lefty, Kremens down at Georgia Tech, Calhoun. You can also go in here. John Chaney's done a great job at Temple. Mike Jarvis is doing one at George Washington.
After the two misses, Maryland gets it back momentarily, but now Kellogg comes up with it. Smith, 13 points and three rebounds as they go to Camby inside.
Not a good pass. Got to throw that ball up higher. Tried to force that pass.
And Maryland getting some substitutes in very quickly as Rhodes checks back into the game along with Simpkins and Booth with 1:38 left to go first half. 40-36, Massachusetts leads it.
Brings in his first team backcourt, brings in Rhodes, brings in Simpkins. They didn't get hurt too much with Bristol on the floor.
Camby with another block.
I'll tell you, what a special dimension that is to a club. That's his fourth block shot at over 100 last year.
One of only five freshmen in NCAA history to have over 100 blocks. For Sean Bradley with the most ever, 172.
Yeah, down at BYU. He blocked one of my shots. I took it right to him when I was at practice one day, and he says, "Dickie D, in your face."
Not surprised.
Kellogg trying to get a high screen.
Padilla, that's another three.
I got Padilla quietly making big shots. He played his senior year in Puerto Rico.
Three threes now for Padilla. Three out of three from three-point land.
He's making the big shot when they need it, giving him a little momentum.
43-36, the lead back up to seven. As Booth will take it, that's a two. Norville tips it out. Hips got it, tipped around. Let's see who they give it to.
Rhodes. I think you got to give it to Rhodes. I would give it to Rhodes.
Could have been Hip or Rhodes. And they're going to give it to Hip.
Rhodes looking like saying, "Where's my deuce? That should be my deuce."
First field goal for Hip in the first half, 43-38.
Spreading the court now, using the clock.
Shot clock and the game clock right together.
3 years ago, you couldn't do this. You couldn't bounce the ball. It would have been a violation. But that's a new rule. He can keep the ball in his hands now. There's no count if he's dribbling, only if he holds it.
Norville draws the foul, can't get it to go.
Enos Norville's going to be a very good player, but you better not play with that ball up on a cylinder.
You just got to let that go. You can't get up there. You got to see if it'll fall down. Norville messing with the ball up there while it's still bouncing around there.
Exactly. Not in a USA. You could do that internationally. Now look at the ball. It's going to hang up there. Got to get away from that thing up on a cylinder. Norville very quick down in the box. I'll tell you, Gary Williams, the first couple of years, it was so tough with that probation, but he kept plugging and working as a very young team. But he told me, you know, he's cautiously optimistic as opposed to where it's running Maryland fever all over. He said, "Dick, we were 8-8 last year in the ACC. In fact," he said, "we lose in the first round of the Atlantic Coast Conference Tournament, and I'm worried about getting an NCAA berth. Then we beat Massachusetts. Everybody went nuts," he said, "because we got everybody back." He said, "but we got to prove that we're really a legitimate top 15 team."
Norville hits them both, 2 seconds left to go. And oh, what a bad foul by Padilla.
That's just a silly foul right there. You're 80 feet from the goal. I mean, you just can't make plays like that. And plus, it's his third foul. That's his third foul. That's a no-no, Edgar.
Padilla, who goes back to Puerto Rico and plays in summer leagues down there, one of several players who originally hailed from Puerto Rico on the Massachusetts roster.
Played in Springfield his junior year in high school. Played his senior year in Puerto Rico. They have a tough summer program down there. Guys like P.J. Carlissimo used to coach down there.
Padilla, pretty good defensive player, had 34 steals a year ago in limited playing time. As Simpkins
will go to the line for Maryland. Their best free throw shooter. He's made 30 of 33 this year. As he missed.
Oh, Padilla's saying thank you. Thank you. Because he knows he's going to feel the wrath of John Calipari at halftime.
Maryland just 12 of 20 at the free throw line today. Well, I tell you, that's a lost art, isn't it, Dick?
Yeah, that's, free throw shooting. They're a much better shooting team than that. They're in the 70s usually, percentage-wise, on that free throw line.
So Simpkins makes one of two, and it's 45-39 with a second left. And that ends the first half. From the Baltimore Arena, we'll return to ABC Raycom College Basketball after this message and a word from our ABC stations. Day. The kid really looked good.
Well, he was very active. I think he rose to the occasion knowing that he's heard so much about Joe Smith. Had a big game last year against Maryland, 32 points. And they needed him because Lou Rowe has really struggled here. We take a look right now. One of my favorite players, though, as we're going to watch number 32, Joe Smith. He comes off the screen, catches triple threat position. He says, no, Lou, you may be a super, but you're not going to check me here. And he splits him, hangs, twists, and converts. He's got great agility and mobility for a big player.
13 points, 3 rebounds in the first half, and then Lou Rowe.
Yeah, Lou Rowe gets the ball from the way they reverse the ball against the pressure, bring it to the high post. The little dump down, Camby to Rowe, great combination, and Lou really under control and poised converts.
Missed his first three shots, hit three of his next four, and then Michael Williams.
They need Michael Williams. They need him offensively. Came off the bench, made a big three here, the little trifecta. Struggled a little bit, though. Took a few bad shots, but remember, he's only coming back. He was suspended for the first game.
Williams, 6 points in the first half, but they got help from Padilla with 9. He hit all of his three-pointers, and Camby with 9 points and 6 rebounds. And even though just the one game in December, folks, we've got a lot of Pizza Hut college basketball coming your way here on ABC Sports. Dick, on January 14th, Virginia, Duke, Arkansas, at Auburn.
Well, I'll tell you that special game, Virginia at Duke. Virginia's been a little disappointment early in the year, and I love Duke. They got a match with Michigan tonight. I love their new kids, Langan, and certainly Wojciechowski from Baltimore, and Ricky Price is for real.
And some other good ones on the 21st, including Kentucky at Vanderbilt, Duke at Florida State, Temple at UMass, and Texas at Oklahoma. And we'll continue in the month of February. We've got some great players we're going to see, too, and we'll have that for you when we come back. We're at halftime, Massachusetts leading Maryland 45-39. We're looking forward to a great year of Pizza Hut College basketball here on ABC Sports. Some great players left, but we're looking forward to some outstanding performers here in this 1994-95 season. And let's take a look at a few of them.
Here are some of the college basketball stars you'll see this winter. Arkansas's Corliss Williamson is one of the dominant big men in the game. Last season, he averaged 20 points in leading the Razorbacks to the national championship. Williamson is nearly unstoppable one-on-one. Maryland's Joe Smith was the ACC Rookie of the Year in 94, leading the league in rebounding with nearly 11 boards per game. With his help this year, the Terrapins could contend in the conference race. Out west, Ed O'Bannon is the reason many experts are picking UCLA. An all-Pac-10 selection last season, O'Bannon has Bruins fans thinking about a return to the glory days in Westwood. Florida State shooting star Bob Serra, the ACC scoring leader last season, has no fear. The 6'5 senior is an All-America candidate for the Seminoles. Duke is looking for a go-to guy. And if senior Cherokee Parks takes charge and becomes a force inside, he could be the next Blue Devil star. Oklahoma is big country, and Bryant Reeves is back for his senior season at Oklahoma State, ready to lead the Cowboys to a possible Big Eight title and another tournament bid. At Arizona, senior Damon Stoudemire finally has the spotlight to himself. He'll need a big year for the Wildcats to make a return trip to the Final Four. Memphis's David Vaughn returned from a debilitating knee injury to lead the Tigers in scoring and rebounding. Now the junior leads a very young team that could surprise. And many experts think North Carolina 6'10 sophomore Rasheed Wallace could be the best big man in the nation. After flashes of brilliance as a backup last season, he gets the chance to excel as a starter. Catch the Stars all winter long.
Nick, here's some other players to watch, some other guys that you like this year.
Well, you got to watch Travis Best, dynamite guard for Georgia Tech. Jerry Stackhouse can put points on a board. Ray O's underrated, can rebound, block shots. Tyus Edney's a penetrator. Sean Respert might be the best guard in the Big Ten. And I'll tell you one thing, Best is some kind of special player. All those guys are going to be on ABC.
Yeah, and we'll return to ABC Raycon College Basketball after this message and a word from our ABC stations.
Years of recognizing the best players in college basketball. This year's nominees include Rasheed Wallace of top-ranked North Carolina, Michigan State's Sean Respert, Wake Forest guard Randolph Childress, and Corliss Williamson of national champion Arkansas. The Ben Naismith Award, celebrating 27 years.
45-39 as we get set to start the second half, and it's been Marcus Camby. Dick, you said he needed to be in the game today.
Well, they had to have him. When he was on that sideline, they certainly were starting to struggle because Rowe didn't have a big game. And look at the numbers right here, the field goal percentage when he's out and when he's on the floor, and that's the reason. He's so agile, he's so mobile. He initiates the fast break, a la Mr. Russell years ago with the Celtics, and there's Lou Rowe with the conversion. If they could get Lou Rowe started big time and get him off offensively, remember, he has three fouls. That could become big.
Last time Maryland led this game, it was at 7-4.
Well, you know, Maryland 0-6, Roger, from three-point range, and they're normally a pretty good three-point shooting team.
Yeah, Massachusetts doesn't rely on the three that much. And it was the three which Maryland used to nail UMass in the NCAA game last year. They hit eight threes, and that was the big difference in the second half.
Well, you know, Massachusetts was up 9 in that game with about 10 minutes to go, and then, as you said, they start knocking down the three. They're shooting about 37% for the year, but they're 0-6 right here in this game.
See, Camby starts the second half as Rowe with the turnaround. Lou Rowe with three fouls, Padilla with three fouls.
Kellogg forces the turnover, forces the little walk. I'll tell you, he does so many of those little things we always talk about, the intangibles.
Simpkins, by the way, there's been a correction. He has just two fouls and not three. So no one with Maryland as we start the second half with three fouls. And once again, Rowe and Padilla both with three. As Kellogg drops it inside. Rowe looks for Camby.
Oh, what a
play.
What a nice combination. The good interior pass, very unselfish, under control. Lou Rowe's got a lot of parts of his game. Smith,
good position.
I'll tell you,
can't let him have it down there.
He's got great parts to his game. He is going to be such a star player on the collegiate level this year. You talk about great players. He and Wallace, what a combination in the ACC.
Kellogg the miss. Hit tips it to Booth, and here comes Maryland. They're down by six.
When in doubt, you go to Jam and Joe.
And Camby blocking.
Yeah, Camby got a piece. They wanted a foul. No call. Refs allowed the play.
Williams starts the second half. So Camby and Williams, who did not start the game, both start the second half.
They're both. This is basically their starting team, Roger. This is basically the club that, when it's crunch time, will be on the floor.
Good move by Camby. Can't get it to go.
Murray's got to get other people involved. Hip has been playing well all year, has not been able to score here today. They got to get him involved and Booth.
Booth has got seven rebounds, though. His hip has it blocked by Bright.
Bright right there in his face. No head fake. You got to use that little head fake. Great man-to-man defense. Booth's doing a good job, though, on Lou Rowe on the inside.
Right to the hole and gets it.
Dante Bright, he's home. He's got all his fans here, all his family. He scored. He said, hey, I'm not worried about this. He said, my cousin and I, we played down at Bojack's, baby, down in the park. We've hooked up so many times.
Scored nearly 2,000 points and had 1,200 rebounds in 4 years at Dunbar.
What a great team, one of the great high school teams. And there was his cousin.
Camby blocked Booth. Jump ball.
They're calling a jump ball now. And now here's an example. Alternate possessions. He blocks the shot, and the ball goes over to Maryland. I hate that rule. They should wipe it out. Let the officials throw the ball up in the air. Now watch this right here. We're going to watch. Boots going to step across the lane. He gives a little shove to get free. Catches it.
Rhodes kicks it back to Simpkins. Just underway second half, 49-41. Massachusetts leads it by eight. That's been their biggest lead.
Simpkins can shoot the three.
Booth. They thought it might have been an offensive foul, but Cruz works his way inside, is able to draw the foul.
Ricky Rose, number four. Is that four on Rose? Look at the pain on his face. Look at the hurt. Look at the pain. Look at the agony. He's got four. Oh, wow. John Calipari's got to get him on the sideline.
Lou Rowe averaging nearly 27 points a game, picks up his fourth foul at the 17-42 mark, Dick. So let's keep an eye on that. And with Massachusetts leading by eight.
Yeah, keep the score right now. 17-42, and they're plus eight. You got to keep that down. 49-41. Lou Rowe to the sideline. He becomes an assistant coach. That was really a forced shot, too, that he fouled him on.
Booth goes to the line. 61% on the year. And this is a Maryland basketball team, Dick. They have made more free throws than their opponents have attempted.
Again, I say we got to be cautious with those stats because of whom they've played. They've really loaded up, beating Colgate, beating University of Maryland, Baltimore County, Loyola, Maryland.
Booth outside. Ronco Norville, who's checked into the game with the rebound.
That was a brick big time. You build a lot of condominiums and a lot of houses and a lot of townhouses with that.
Massachusetts with the basketball, leading by seven, and now that Camby's not there, Dick, who do they look to?
Well, certainly right now, you got to get Dante Bright involved a little bit offensively.
Hit with a reach, and now he blocks Williams on his way to the hoop. Calipari wanted to foul out front.
Michael Williams on a perimeter can score, and he also got to get Bright a little scoring on that wing.
Try to get it into Norville, and they're going to call the foul inside. Going to be on Booth, and that's his third.
You got to watch also for a little letdown when you're Maryland, just because Rose on the sideline. A lot of times, teams psychologically, there's that little letdown, thinking the star is sitting on a bench, and the other club picks it up a notch.
Last year, these two teams met in the 10th game of the year. Massachusetts beat Maryland 94-80. Then in Wichita, second round of the NCAA regional, 95-87. Maryland with a huge upset.
They beat them not only by 14, it was really a plus 20 most of that game.
Hand check called by Dick Capel.
Not allowed to do it. They're calling that this year. Fred Barakat is constantly in contact with his officials, the ACC commissioner for officiating, and I think he's the best in the business.
X3 hit with his first foul. Hit with just 3 points.
This is a big game for Maryland. I'll tell you why it's a big game. Psychologically, if they want to be recognized as a legitimate big-time club, they have to beat somebody big early in the year. And their schedule doesn't give them a chance to play that many tough teams early, so this game becomes big to them.
Good spin move by Bright. Can't get the roll to go. He's got great legs. 8 rebounds for Booth now.
A win like this helps you mentally when you go into that tough ACC to believe you can win. Because remember last year, they were 8-8. They lose first round to Virginia in the ACC tournament. So reality, they were 8-9 against ACC competition.
Bad pass right there, thrown away. Battle on the floor and jump ball.
I think the one thing that has been established early, I don't care what Massachusetts' record is as you look at Lou Rowe on the sideline, they are proven without a doubt as you look at his numbers versus today and coming into the game, 26.7, that they are going to be a contender and they are not a pretender. They are legitimate and their team to be reckoned with in the postseason after this season is concluded. They will be legitimate.
Steele, Simpkins.
Nice move by Simpkins to cut off the defensive player to get the good angle for the layup.
49-44.
Well, now you got to pick it up. You got to get a little emotional. Rose on the sideline. There's a big sequence for Massachusetts.
Maryland almost had another steal. Loses the ball. And the refs are letting him go, and Simpkins will bring it down.
They score here. This place is going to explode.
Won't go, and he draws the foul.
Remember, it was 49-41 when he went to the sideline. It's 49-44 for a chance to get it to three on the free throw line.
Foul was on Bright. His second.
He's like, I can't believe it. Look, he's like, I can't believe it. He's like, the perspiration in an Armani special. Look at him, he's dressing at 35 like his man, Rick Pitino down at Kentucky. Pitino was on a selection committee as a graduate of the University of Massachusetts. Played a role in the hiring of Calipari out of Pittsburgh as an assistant.
Rhodes with 12 points, and Dick, he's been getting it done offensively with one steal today, so 24 on the year and two from breaking Walt Williams' record.
Lou Rose, certainly right now, you can miss the free throw. You talked about seniors having great starts. Eddie O'Bannon, Cherokee Parks, been super down at Michigan. And certainly Lou Rose and Damon Stoudemire also out of the game.
Massachusetts has not scored since Rose sat down with his fourth. It's a four-point game. As they go inside, Bright challenging Smith that time and draws the foul.
I thought, Roger, he would be their number one option, that they would look to try and pick up some scoring on the inside. And Bright is responding by wanting the basketball, but now he's got to convert free throws.
Foul was on Rhodes, his third.
He's going to get Camby back in.
As Bright will go to the line. He had a big game, didn't he, against Arkansas, Dick? Yeah, Dante Bright.
Well, they all played well. It was such a great team effort. I'll tell you something, though, Arkansas showed a lot of character after that game. When they regrouped in 48 hours, Nolan Richardson had his team ready to respond against Georgetown. Oh, Gary, come on out, Gary. Gary, be calm.
Bright 88% from the free throw line. You see his season average at over 16, and now with 6 points today. Timeout on the floor, 15:30 to go, and it's 51-45, UMass with the lead.
C Sports, Raycom, college basketball. Brought to you by State Farm Insurance. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. Buick, makers of the concept car you can drive. The 1995 Riviera. Perk Plus shampoo and conditioner. Great hair, no fuss. And Siemens, for leading-edge technologies in electronic and electrical engineering. Depend on Siemens precision thinking.
Tomorrow night on ABC, brand new episodes of America's Funniest Home Videos, and On Our Own, followed by a holiday movie event. Dustin Hoffman, Julia Roberts, and Robin Williams star in the network premiere of Hook, starting at 8, 7 Central Time tomorrow night on ABC. And that's what Dick used to get. You used to get the hook, didn't you?
I saw Julia Roberts one time on a Notre Dame football game. I walked over to her, introduced her, looked at me, said, "Who's this wacko?" She had no clue who I was. My ego was totally deflated, just like in a hotel last night. Katarina Vitt comes in a hotel. She's by the lobby. I get on the elevator. She had no clue who I was, Roger.
You're saying you're not big in the figure skating.
Oh, so. Wow. Scott Hamilton said hello, though, as we watch here the action.
I don't know, Dick, if you think Julia Roberts and Katarina Vitt should know who you are, we're in a lot of trouble. That's all I can say.
I get guys like you know me.
Let's watch the 45, 15-14, left to go.
2-1-2, here's the 2-1-2 half-court press. That's what bothered Mass during the tournament last year in the second half.
Bright just loses it going inside.
They're trying to utilize dribble penetration into a gap. They got to get a little bit more ball movement like they did earlier. But remember, without Lou Rowe on the floor, somebody's got to step up.
There's Bright off the glass. Well, it can be the follow.
And he'll step up. A little jam by Camby on the offensive rebound. They really excel offensively on the glass. 63-33. Repeated again coming into this game for the season.
13 points, 9 rebounds for Camby as Smith takes it in and draws the foul. The foul on Marcus Camby, and that'll be his first.
Watch the offensive rebound, the missed shot. Massachusetts does a great job of attacking the glass. That's one of the elements of playing aggressive basketball. And you're forcing turnovers, you're blocking shots, and you're getting on the offensive boards.
Smith, 15 points, 5 rebounds, 2 blocks. He had 93 blocks a year ago.
Hey, Roger, I'm just thinking this. I'll give you the rest of the country. I'll take the ACC, and I'll line up with Joe Smith, Cherokee Parks, Rasheed Wallace. Give me Travis Best and Randolph Childress. Come off the bench with Surra and Stackhouse. Give me those 7, and you can have the rest of the country, and I will blow you out, baby.
I can have that guy?
You can have anybody you want in the country. You can take any. Give me those 7 in the ACC. I mean, that ACC's got great stars. This guy may be the star of stars.
Smith gets them both. He's got 17 now.
There's that half court now. They try to force you to go sideline.
Padilla, Kellogg, Wright, Dingle, Camby in there. Look at Camby from the side. Won't go, and Simpkins with the rebound. Smith was up front, couldn't get it to him.
Yeah, he was up. Simpkins had his head down. That's a no-no for young kids dribbling the ball. Always have your head up so you have vision of the people up in front of you. And Wayne is an excellent ball handler. There's that reversal.
Smith, good position there.
Strong move! I tell you, he is so strong. He is a BTP-er. Wow, is he a big-time player. He works so hard to get free for the basketball inside. He's so active. Gary Williams is a great teacher in drop step moves, post moves. I've seen Gary work at camps. Look at the crowd giving him a hand. They love him. Jamming Joe.
Foul on Camby, his second.
Watch him get the ball in deep. See, Camby can't check him there. Camby relying on the block shot allows him to get deep position. That's an M&M against most people inside, a mismatch.
Ducky stepped on somebody's foot. The turn of the ankle. Smith will go to the line. A standing ovation from the crowd here in Baltimore.
He's got the no sock look. He's got the no sock
like
look.
That.
Look at
that
new look.
I like
no
it.
Sock. I don't like it.
I don't like
all these looks.
I like it.
I want to go back to the old days.
See, I like you. You would wear those.
I like the hot pants.
Yeah,
I like
okay.
The hot pants.
The real high pants.
Camby inside.
Yoko and Smith a rebound.
Yeah, great position inside, Marcus.
Simpkins to pull up for three. Yoko rebound underneath. Lucas can't get it. He's just checked into the game.
Maryland's got to find a way to get some perimeter shots to fall. Normally a pretty good wing shooting team, especially Simpkins, shoots 43%. Last year, he shot 43% from 3-point range.
Massachusetts has only scored 4 points since Rose sat down. 4 minutes have passed. As the foul.
John Calipari's trying to buy minutes, buy time on that clock until he can get Lou Rowe on the floor to be productive. He's really situation like to bring him in probably about the 6 minute mark.
Booth just picked up his fourth foul and he'll come out of the game.
I think Keith's been a little nervous. I don't think they'll admit it, but I think playing at home, playing against his cousin, you try a little extra hard, and I think it affects your play.
Williams testing it inside, gets it to Camby. Offensive foul, so Camby's picked up three quick fouls as we're at the Baltimore Arena. Roger Clavell, Dick Vitale, the University of Massachusetts, and the University of Maryland with the Minutemen leading 53-49, 13-28 left to go in this basketball game. Lou Rowe had to sit down at the 17:42 mark with his fourth foul, and Camby has picked up three quick fouls.
Yeah, there's Camby with three now, and also Padilla, who knocked down three threes in the first half, has three. So foul trouble beginning to mount for Massachusetts.
Oh, get it out of there.
Look at Norville.
Bristol took it in, and Norville sent it out.
Yeah, Norville, very active. He's got long arms. I'll tell you, the one thing Massachusetts has, though, is the depth. And that depth could be a key factor in a big-time game like this. They got Camby and Rowe on the sideline.
Oh, what a big three for Williams.
What a big three. Big possession. That helps to buy some time.
56-49, lead back up to seven.
He's knocked down his fourth three. Rowe's trying to post inside. Trying to invert their guards.
Rhodes, the left hand, Lucas, the offensive board, up and in.
That's what they need out of Mario. They need him to give them some rebound and some defense, not only looking to shoot the jump shot.
Lucas with five and five rebounds. Williams again, that's his third.
He can get in the zone, Roger. He's very explosive offensively. What a big lift by the senior. The two big stars are on the sideline. He says, hey, the little guy's going to carry you, Coach C. Don't worry, Coach Calipari, I'm going to carry you.
59-51. That's been the biggest lead for the Minutemen. Back up to eight.
And that's what it was when Rowe went out.
Exactly.
8 points with 17:42. Going to buy some time. He's going to bring in Camby now. Michael Williams loves the challenge at the end of the game. Made a big shot to beat North Carolina last year. Five times he's beaten clubs at the buzzer.
Williams, remember he hit the shot in regulation to tie North Carolina, forced it into OT, hit the three-pointer.
UMass wins. Yeah, twice did. Against Temple, killed them at the end of the game, and then against Oklahoma, sent one in off the glass for a game winner.
John Chaney wishes he's graduated them out of here.
Lucas has it swatted down by Camby.
I tell you, Camby brings such a dimension. We keep talking about it. You said, well, what does that do for a club? It forces clubs to look on the perimeter. As we look at the rebound and total, basically even, except Mass has done a little better job offensively. But Gary's got to be pleased that they've sort of neutralized them on the glass.
Camby's got five rejections.
And not only that, he forces clubs to want to pull up and shoot the little jump shot instead of driving.
See, there's a jumper three.
He says, I can go inside, I can go outside. You name it, I can do it. I am complete. Jammin' Joe Smith is the real deal. He's genuine. He's solid goal, and he's an all-Rolls-Royce and a first-team All-American.
Williams for three. And Massachusetts gets it. Hey, that was the first three-pointer for Maryland. One of nine from three-point land, and the big man has to go get it.
And they were 0 for 6 in the first half. Look at John Calipari right in the face of Norville with affection and coaching. He loves, again, both coaches are so emotional and just loves to coach.
It may be December, but the action is hot. The Chiefs and the Dolphins give it all they got.
Hey, they got to get a three-pointer, and who's going to deliver it? Hip kicks it out. Hey, right there, that's no Joe Schmo, baby. That's no ordinary Joe. That's the real Joe, Jammin' Joe. 1 for 9, though, Maryland from three-point range. What can he not do, number 32? Inside, outside,
hey, Dick,
he's quick and agile.
He's hit 5 three-pointers in his career now, and Maryland is 4-0. So they have won every game he did a three-pointer, and let's see if that holds true here today.
You come out with these stats, I got to give you credit. Where do you get that?
I don't know.
You beat me with all that data. Now here's trying to use some time, spreading the court.
Trying to stay close to him. That's all I try to do. 59-54, a five-point lead right in the lane, comes up short, and Padilla gets it back.
Under control, backs it out, shows some poise. I really think to be a special basketball team, you got to cover three areas of the floor. The point guard slot, the wing, and the posting inside.
Williams! Let's count it. They said two.
Two-point shot by Michael Williams. They cover the point guard area really well, Massachusetts. They covered the wings exceptionally well, and they got post-up ability. And anytime you can have those three elements, you got a chance to be a special team.
61-54, 10.5 to go. Tough move on the baseline by Smith. Hip trying to come over the top.
Simpkins has really been quiet. The Gamatha High School star played for Morgan Wooten. Certainly one of the premier high school coaches of all time. Gary's got to get some productivity out of Dwayne, looking to shoot the basketball as Kellogg comes back on the floor.
That was on Norville, that's his third.
And yeah, Norville, you got some fouls to give. When you got a deep bench, Edgar Padilla goes out, it's knocked down 4 threes. This kid's going to be a good player, Norville. He's very quick, he's agile, he can block shots, front the court. You know, Gary's had an interesting career. He comes over, first of all, he starts out with Dr. Tom Davis. Tom Davis has him over at Lafayette. He then brings him with him. He goes over to, he brings him to Boston College. He goes back. Then he coaches American University for 4 years. Does a solid job. Comes over, takes over Boston College. Told me his best team he ever had was 83, Sweet 16 with Michael Adams. The year before, under Dr. Tom, they went to the Sweet 8, I believe, or the Final 8, and they had John Bagley with that club at Boston College. And then he went to Ohio State and would have had a great team when Jimmy Jackson arrived.
Rhodes with the offensive board. Hip gets it back. And
he's fouled. Massachusetts is a very physical team. They're not afraid to make you have to go to the line because they got people they can rotate.
That's the fourth foul on Marcus Camby, and he's picked up those four fouls in the last 8 minutes.
I'll tell you, John's going to have to really regroup as we watch Marcus Camby. Well, anytime you take a swing, you're going to watch him right here wind up, basically
miss.
Not a good call. No. Not a good foul. Not a good foul.
So Hip will go to the line. He hit one of his last two, and now he's missed another. So
With a six-point lead, you can take Camby out. Some coaches, when you have two stars like Camby and Rowe, what you try to do, Roger, you play one and you keep one out as insurance, and then you rotate him in. He has decided at the 10-minute mark, plus six, he has decided to put both of them out. Lucas misses the follow, and Maryland gets it back, doing a great job on the offensive glass. Underneath, Rhodes has it knocked away. Maryland's got to score here. This would be psychologically bad if they don't get it.
Oh, God, it goes in.
They needed that. Joe
Smith. Like Joe Smith.
I thought it was Joe Smith. That was a big possession. I think John Calipari might need a timeout to get his team together. I think he needed a T.O., baby.
They gave it to Hip. They gave the tip in to Hip. If they hit this, 57, 4 points. Lucas.
Get a T.O., baby. Get a T.O., Johnny C. Get a T.O. You better call that timeout. They're exploding. And college basketball, it is special, baby.
Above the rim, this game is being played.
Well, they're really attacking the glass. Maryland knows this is a big possession. With Rowe and Camby sitting down with four fouls, they got to convert. I would right now, well, he doesn't. See, smart move. He brings in Lewis Rowe. I was simply going to say that basically with Camby out, you have to have one on the floor, and you have one as insurance. And Lou Rowe has got to be intelligent right now as he plays, knowing he has four fouls.
Maryland's got 14 offensive rebounds, six in the last 90 seconds.
And that was a Camby and Rowe on the sideline. Smart move by Calipari, getting Rowe back on the floor just to give him some presence inside.
Kellogg hesitated and got it to Rowe. Now Dinkle with it. Williams for three. Look at the rebound by Dinkle in here.
Dana Dinkle with a little jingo bingo as he steps up. It's a good offensive rebound.
Somebody else has got to step it up now, Dick, for UMass. 63-59, 9:04 to go. Lucas driving on the baseline, and traveling start.
Yeah, he definitely, good ball, he skipped. What a pick up his pivot foot.
The last time Maryland led in this game, it was 7-4. They've been able to close the gap to one in the first half. They got it down to two here in the second half.
Here's where coaching becomes so important, making those good decisions on that sideline. John Calipari's got to be a little bit of a gambler right now, and he's certainly taking a chance, playing Lou Rowe. There's his counterpart, Gary Williams. He knows his club's going to make a little run with Camby out and Rowe with four fouls.
Couple of former point guards, Calipari, Williams.
Yeah, Gary was a much better player. You tell after John and I said, no contest. Trying to take some time off with each possession. They're trying to get some good execution, offensive efficiency rating. They're trying to make each possession count.
Seven on the shot clock, and they throw it away.
But the one good thing is they did use some clock. Right now, I would attack Lou Rowe. I would attack whoever is, well, he's guarding Smith. I don't think there's any doubt. You go right at Lou Rowe.
Padilla comes back in, and Kellogg checks out as Padilla had three three-pointers in the first half.
He's trying to get Camby. I think he'd like the clock to go to 5 minutes. Score would dictate when they bring him in. I would go right at Rowe.
Deal. UMass gets a steal from Dingle.
What a quick play by David Dingle from St. Raymond's in Bronx in New York. He's made two big plays, Dingle, the offensive rebound and the steal. He's a tough defensive player. Here goes DD. There goes Dana Dingle. Jingle bingo mango.
Oh, wait. What was that again?
I don't know
dingle,
what it is.
Jingle.
It's jingling right there, the scoreboard, and that's all Calipari's here.
I'll tell you what, he's a terrific defensive player, Dana Dingle, and was able to throw it down as he went high that time. Off the steal, the defense created the offense, and it's 65-59 with a timeout. 8:12 left to go from Baltimore.
Legendary twosomes. Wait till you see the pros get together. The biggest names in golf pair up for the Diners Club matches next on ABC Sports.
Now it's time for the Pizza Hut delivery of the game, and take a little extra cheese on this one.
Well, Dana Dingo's going to take it right to the rack. He takes it with authority, and he jingles. Hey, little jingle bells. It's Santa time. And he delivers. His coach said, I love that, baby. He's the delivery man. Well, back out again.
Hasn't scored.
We'll see what they do.
Second half.
What they do now, they bring in Camby and keep him out. He's rotating to make sure he has one of his stars on the baseline on the floor. Smart move. I'll tell you, Roger, if he'd have kept both out, Maryland would have taken the lead. Dingle tries to complete the three-point play. 60% free throw shooter, and he gets it. Plays out of, came out of a great high school program in New York. Maryland has not done the job at the free throw line today, just 56%. They've had more opportunities than Massachusetts. 66-59, 7-point UMass lead. Lucas spins, but I'll tell you, right there on the ball, and it's the jump ball.
Lucas has really tried to assert himself offensively, but I don't know if you want him to be the first option.
In this sequence, you got Camby playing Joe Smith. Camby's got four fouls. The previous sequence, when he walked, Camp Rowe was on the floor. He had four fouls, and he was checking Joe Smith. See, he can't guard him. He can't guard him. He came up empty. He's going to let him go right up.
Well, he's been camped in the lane forever, and finally the ball comes loose to Williams. He's got Dingle on the wing, and in.
Dingle has made three big baskets. Joe Smith had an easy layup at the other end, but he lost possession of the basketball because Camby could not guard him.
Dingle's got 8 points in the second half. He only had 4 points in the first half, and now it's a 68-59, 9-point lead, the biggest lead for UMass in this game.
Yeah, I would throw it right into Joe again down here inside. Camby's going to let him take it right to the goal if they get it to him.
Rhodes for three, won't go. Kellogg battling. Booth comes up with it. And the foul inside on UMass.
Joe Smith right now knows Camby. See, they slipped the ball, slipped. He went right by Camby because Camby's got four fouls. He's just standing there. See, he's just making like a traffic cop, but he can't get possession of the ball. The ball's slipping and sliding.
Foul was on Kellogg, and now Lou Rowe is checked back in. Camby sits down. 7-17 left to go in this game.
See how he's rotating both guys, doing a smart job on that sideline, making sure he has a presence on the floor, an attitude, a presence. That's something Michigan always had when they had Weber and Juwan Howard. Certain players give you presence.
Yeah, John Calipari was telling us before the game, in the Kansas game, he really struggled, and he said his team just felt like at some point in time they were going to take that game over, and he said Kansas really took it to him.
Well, Kansas had great guard play, and they also have three big guys that can rotate, and Ray LaFrance, along with Allen Iverson and Felipe Lopez, certainly have been three instant hits as diaper dandies. Here's the 2-1-2 now. Hasn't really bothered Massachusetts today as much. Oh, they turned it over there. Oh, there's a foul. That's five. That's five. Yeah,
that's Lou Rowe. That is Lou Rowe. Well, he was going for the loose ball that time.
His instincts told him to go for the loose ball. You can't fault the kid. You play hard. You dive for the ball. He had no idea of a player being there. He was going after the basketball. That's pure instincts. You watch. He sees the loose ball, and there's the contact, and that's number five.
When you're an aggressive player, Dick, you're a warrior like Lou Rowe. You go after every ball. You can't think four fouls out there in a situation like that.
You can't criticize him there. He was going for the ball. He had no idea where the Maryland player was.
6 points, 4 rebounds, 3 of 9 shooting. Didn't play much in the second half. Came in averaging nearly 27 points a game.
That tells you how good this Massachusetts team is. They can be +7 out of sight here in Baltimore, playing Maryland in front of a lot of their fans, and they can be +7 with Lou Rowe, 20 points under his average. That tells me that this club is a contender.
Joe Smith will go to the line. Maryland 20 of 34 from the free throw line today.
Yeah, really struggling on that line. Normally, as we said, in the mid-70s. The reason I keep mentioning that they're a contender is because coming over, when I was traveling from the North Carolina Villanova game, I had some guy tell me, and argue, he said, oh, come on, they're pretenders. They're not for real Massachusetts. I said, you can't be serious. They are definitely going to be a legitimate top 10 team all year.
Smith averaging 19.9, 9.7 rebounds.
And I'll tell you, Maryland is legit. Now, Maryland to make a run would roll out of the game. This has got to be Maryland's time right here.
.68-63, 5-point Massachusetts lead, less than 7 minutes to go.
Kellogg and Williams, very experienced on the perimeter.
Deal. Kellogg loses it.
Got to push somebody to the middle of the floor. See, the foul lane area is wide open. Nobody's flashing to the post. Simpkins doing a great job on Kellogg. He's created a couple of turnovers in the last few minutes. And the foul to reaching outside by Hip.
Trying to utilize the shot clock, trying to get some time off. Camby with four. He's got to still play hard. He can't just be a guy that's going to be stationary out there. He's got to be active.
Third foul on X-ray Hip. And that'll send Williams to the line. Mike Williams made three big threes in this half. Likes crunch time. This is a big one right there.
Maryland's got to go a little inside-outside action and try to get a wing jump shot, a three-point shot. This guy can knock it down, play a little two-man game.
Smith looking at more.
Camby can't guard him, baby. That's an MC. That's no contest. That's like comparing Roseanne Barr, baby, against Cindy Crawford in a beauty contest.
68-65, three-point Massachusetts lead. Tipped away.
Well, I'll tell you what, beautiful job that time by Keith Booth.
Joe Smith catching it inside. Camby with four, can't check him. They try to give some help with Bingo. He is so smooth. He's got that quick release, that great drop step. Big time in every way imaginable.
Sophomore from Norfolk, Virginia. And he has been a surprise last year, but no longer a surprise. He is one of the solid players in the country.
Look at Bright go inside and get two.
Dante Bright out of high school, out of Dunbar, was top five USA today. All the All-American teams. Great legs, very quick player.
Booth.
Rhodes in. Nice cut without the ball by Johnny Rhodes. One of the lost arts of basketball, move without the ball. If you get good ball movement and player movement, you'll get good shots.
Rhodes with 14.
Offensive foul on Keller.
Bob Donato with the call. They are really emotional. They are really fired up.
Four fouls on Keller.
Well, there's the charge. Oh, there's no doubt about it. Great defensive play by Dwayne Simpkins. He says, I drive you, I beat you, and I take the charge. He beat him to the spot.
Remember, Simpkins, a junior from Fort Washington, Maryland, has really played an outstanding game today, not in the points category, handling the ball, and playing good defense out front.
Well, he wants to get it to his buddy.
Look at Smith.
And there's his buddy.
It won't go.
Can't handle him inside. I think they got to rotate someone else to guard Smith and have Camby in help position. He can't play him head-to-head.
Real, real tough for Massachusetts having Lou Rose sitting on that sideline.
Foul was on Williams, his second. Good foul by Williams as he reached in because you knew Smith was going to take it.
Oh, yeah, he had simple conversion.
UMass started the year by beating Arkansas, the number one ranked team in the nation. They went out and Kansas knocked them off when they were number one.
Shows you there's a lot of knowledge.
Speaking of Arkansas, if you like this game, folks, we've got a lot more great college basketball coming your way on the 14th. Check your local listings, Virginia Duke, Arkansas, Auburn, UCLA, and Washington State, Tulane, and Cincinnati.
I was surprised yesterday, Canisius beat Cincinnati. Meeks is a heck of a player.
Gets them both down. It's a one-point game with 5 minutes to go.
You would have to say Uncle Mo, momentum. You would have to say it's got to be on a hurt side. Walking violation.
Padilla. Now they call it. Now they call it.
He called it earlier. Nobody heard it. Bob Donato blew the whistle earlier for a walking violation. And they didn't hear his whistle. I think Uncle Mo has arrived on the side of Gary Williams with Lou Rowe out of the game.
4:51 left to go, and it's a one-point ball game.
Wow.
Wow.
Z Sports. Raycom College Basketball. has been brought to you by Pizza Hut, where great food and fun times bring people together. Discus Athletic Activewear, Discus Athletic, the way America plays. And Toyota and their full line of quality cars and trucks. Toyota, I love what you do for me.
Roger Twaddle, Dick Vitale back with you in Baltimore. Joe Smith has scored 9 of Maryland's last 13 points to get them within one. Doesn't shock me at all. They're going to know to check him. Now they're putting Norvell on him.
Here goes the inside.
Oh, what was that? No call. Smith and doesn't get the roll.
Little inside-outside action and back to the interior. Almost had the walk-in violation on Simpkins.
I want to remind you, coming up next here on ABC Sports, the Diners Club matches from PGA West out in La Quinta, California. Members of the PGA Tour, Senior PGA Tour, LPGA. And one of the featured matches, Nicholas and Palmer against Chichi Rodriguez and Jim Tent.
Joe Smith really taking advantage of the fact that Marcus Camby cannot guard him because he has 4 fouls. Really stifles a player of the ability of Camby, that he can't be as aggressive as he'd like to be with 4 fouls.
Roger Tribal, Dick Vitale at the Baltimore Arena. The University of Massachusetts and the University of Maryland tied at 70 with 4:36 left to go. And Smith can give the Terrapins their first lead since the first moments of the game, and he does. And he scored 11 of the last 15 for the Maryland Terrapins, and it's their first lead since it was 7-4.
And the crowd responds.
Quickly at the other end, bodies crashing down upon one another. Booth came down on Camby.
Looks like he hurt his back. Got him for a walk-in violation. Keith Booth came down really hard. Camby goes up. He tries to get the good look, but doesn't get the good angle. Actually, Booth comes down on Camby as well.
Right on the hip. Right on his hip. So the story in the second half has been foul trouble for Massachusetts. Rowe has fouled out of the game. Camby's got 4.
Booth has to go out or he gets charged with a timeout. He seems okay, and that's the good news.
71-70. Maryland leads it. Massachusetts taking it inbounds.
What a present you lose by losing Lou Rowe to foul. That's a walk again. They're walking. Point of emphasis this year is to travel. You got to release that ball before you lift that pivot foot.
Turnover by Massachusetts. They've got 19. Maryland with 18.
Let's see the matchup now on Joe Smith. Who guards him? If it's Camby, I'm coming right at him. If I'm Maryland, I'm going right at him. If Camby's going to check him, I take the ball right to the hole, bring it inside to him.
Collision down low as Kellogg hit the deck. Booth working inside. Booth gets it back. Blocked by Camby. And Kellogg comes up with it.
I don't understand that possession. You got Joe Smith, he's on fire, they can't check him. Camby's trying to guard him.
Yes, Marcus Camby!
Steps outside to the wing.
Camby with 15.
And trying to be so careful defensively, he's almost letting Smith do what he wants, yet they don't take advantage of it. Joe's got to go inside and want the ball.
UMass back on top by 1. Smith is... Yeah, he's tied up inside, jump ball.
Dingle does a great job with a double down.
The possession arrow goes to Massachusetts. Hey, this is December. Feels almost like tournament time with these two teams, huh?
That's unbelievable. You can feel the electricity, the excitement. That's what these matchups are about. It's not Cupcake City.
3:20 left to go. Williams in the lane, the pull-up pop hits it.
He's a big-time player. Does he really respond? He makes the 3 big threes here when Lou Rowe got in trouble to start the second half. And there he is with that clutch little middle-range jump shot.
74-71, three-point. UMass lead with 3 minutes to go.
Maryland trying to spread the core and isolate some people, get a little one-on-one maneuvers. There's Bright's playing his cousin. Look at his 2 cousins going head-to-head. Dante Bright against Keith Booth.
Kellogg with the reach-in foul. And that's five on Derek Kellogg.
Watch Booth inside, number 22, trying to work to get some good middle range post position. There he is in the lane. That's his first cousin. They played high school together. Thursday night against Keith Booth. He said, hey, we play against each other so often in the summer at Bojack's. It's a great park where all the stars assemble. I'm here in Baltimore. John Calipari trying to earn the mega dollars he makes now on the sideline as a star in the coaching fraternity.
Well, coming up next on ABC Sports, it's golf's top names. They pair up in a brand new match play showdown from the Senior Tour, the PGA Tour, and the LPGA. They'll battle it out in match play action at the Diners Club Matches. That's coming up next here on ABC Sports.
You know, John Calipari's put some heat about the academics end, and my feeling is, you know, if the players don't graduate, I have a problem. With Lou Rowe and Kellogg and these guys, Michael Williams, but as long as they graduate, he's had eight players, Roger. Six have graduated, and to me, prior to his arrival, they didn't have a player graduate in 5 years. So the bottom line is, they are walking down the aisle, and to me, that's what it's all about.
Now, Booth, all of his points from the free throw line. He's now 6 of 7, and he's got 11 rebounds.
Yeah, he was tough in the second half. He's become a little bit more active.
Kellogg,
he's a very strong player.
Kellogg fouled out of the game.
And that really gives them a leader on the sideline in terms of their seniors. And right now, Calipari's playing with two of his key players sitting next to him. Something he didn't want.
Hip got the rebound now and stripped away, and Padilla comes up with it.
Now Padilla and Williams, they still have a solid backcourt. Williams a little bit more offensive-minded.
74-72. UMass leads it by two with 2:30 left to go in this game.
Certainly if you're UMass, you want to win it in regulation. OT, they're really being a problem. With Kellogg out and Rowe out, Camby with four, using some time.
Using that clock as it goes down under 10 now.
They get it to Williams. He's their first option on a perimeter.
Or three, and it looked like Simpson might have got a piece of it, but the follow underneath, and the big move by Bright.
Bright does the job. Lou Rowe cheering now. Become a cheerleader. Monte Bright back home here in Baltimore. It's a good offensive play.
4-point lead with less than two to go.
Big possession. Big possession.
Tipped around. Camby gets the rebound. Padilla to Williams. Oh, he got bumped. Hit from behind.
He got bumped. No foul call. He got bumped.
And Rose loses it. And UMass gets it back.
Justice was served because there was a foul on the other end of the floor, not called. Look at Gary, he wants a hole. But there's the bump right here. Now look at Michael Williams. You're not supposed to allow any hand checking. I mean, he gets stripped. I mean, but there's no question there was contact.
And we've got a timeout. 1:37 left to go here in Baltimore. Massachusetts leads Maryland 76-72. Roger Twyville, Dick Vitale back with you. 1:37 left to go. UMass leads Maryland 76-72. Rowe is fouled out. Kellogg is fouled out. Camby and Norville with four. And for Maryland, Booth with four.
I think this is a major, major win for Massachusetts if they can hold on and get the W to win away from home with Lou Rowe out a lot of minutes and Kellogg on the sideline and to be able to hold on against a really outstanding Maryland team. This would be a big, big win for their program.
Oh, and Camby goes up over the top and is able to get that ball. Simpkins was right there for the potential steal.
Maryland trying to invite a trap. They're going to spread the court. They want to use the clock, get the high possession shot, little dribble penetration, maybe a dump down. See, right now there's a count going on. You can't hold the ball. You can dribble it and there's no count. But if you hold it, there's a 5-second count that becomes in effect.
Very close to over and back that time for Padilla.
Got to go meet the basketball, trying to lay a high screen.
Williams for three, way outside with five on the shot clock, and they get it back. As happens so often on those three-point attempts from long range, the long carom, and UMass was able to get it back with less than a minute to go, and the reach-in foul.
Now it comes down to that really special art, shooting free throws, something that's really been a dilemma for many colleges.
Booth is now fouled out, so that's his fifth.
Really picked up his intensity in the second half. I don't even know if the word is really intensity, but he picked up his game, became a little bit more active.
Booth fouls out with 11 rebounds and 6 points, all at the free throw line. 54 seconds left to go.
Great matchup, though, in terms of early in the season. I think these matchups are really special to see these heavyweights go head-to-head.
Dick, we're seeing these sort of games played early in the year rather than the games you talk about so often where a big team like a Maryland or a Massachusetts will play a Division II school or 1AA. And as you look down the road toward tournament time, a lot of that is looking back on the teams you played and how you played them.
Well, obviously, there's no question about that. You find the strengths and weaknesses of your club. As you look here at Maryland, per game, scoring big, but we said they haven't really beaten some real giants. This is a game I thought psychologically that they really need, because going into the ACC, this is a situation where you want to go in with some confidence. And right now, they wonder, as you look here at Michigan State, Nebraska going to overtime. Sean Respect can flat out play.
Wright goes to the line.
Maryland's got a Towson State. They have, for example, American coming up on their schedule. And they've beaten the likes of University of Maryland, Baltimore County, Colgate. They did well out in the Maui Classic before they lost to Arizona State, beat a good Utah team. But this is the win Gary really wants. Not over yet.
Hey, this kid stepped up for 10 second-half points. Dante Wright, 12 on the day, 10 in the second half, and 78-72. UMass by 6 with 50 seconds to go. Simpkins takes it strong inside and draws the foul.
They cleared out, ran a little isolation for Simpkins, going to the basket, trying to get the conversion. With 6 points, you're looking at a two-possession game.
And Camby's fouled out.
Yeah, it was Camby that stepped over. I wasn't sure, but, you know, blinding that left eye, got the camera guy blocking our view here. But that is a big foul. That's why, right now, John Calipari's got to pray that this baby doesn't go to an OC.
Hey, heads-up play by Simpkins. He just took him right in at the big man that time. Camby, 15 points, 11 rebounds, and 7 block shots.
Well, I'll tell you right now, you look at Massachusetts, there's no real presence on that baseline. Someone's going to have to step to the ball, because Maryland's going to go to their real tenacious full-court trap after the free throw line. And Simpkins is a good free throw shooter, so give him the chance to get into that press.
13,332. Now, capacity here at the Baltimore Arena.
You mentioned the big matchups. What makes it so special, losses aren't really, you know, a crucial situation like they are in football, where a team loses early and they're out of the hunt.
Right.
You know, that's why they got to have a playoff.
That's the beauty of basketball.
They got to have a playoff, because in basketball, everybody's 0-0 at least when you start the postseason in March and you play it on the court. You don't let the pollsters decide.
You see Roe, Kellogg, and Camby have all fouled out. Booth has fouled out for Maryland. Simpkins, their best free throw shooter, 90% on the season, goes to the line. Look at that.
Wow. Well, Gary can't believe it either. Rolling his eyes, Billy Hahn, fine assistant, sitting behind him.
Maryland, 27 of 42 from the free throw line. He's missed 2 out of 3 today. And look at this, 3 out of 4. Quickly now, here comes Padilla. Wise move to hold it up, and then he's trampled.
Smart play by Ezra Padilla. Rather than put the ball up in the air, possible turnover. Now they go to the line. Team showed a lot of guts, a lot of character with their stars on the sideline. Been in foul trouble most of the afternoon. The second half, hanging on against a very aggressive, athletic, and a very solid Maryland team.
Third foul on Simpkins as Padilla will go to the line.
Look at these three assistant coaches. I mean, they don't want those three guys sitting there. Calipari says, I want them on the floor.
Kellogg fouls out. Camby fouls out. Rowe fouls out. Look at Rowe. I'm a coach now. I'm going to be like a coach.
No, he wants to play. He wants to play. He's going to play at the next level.
That was the first free throw for Padilla this year. Remember, he hit 3 threes in the first half. And he nails them both.
Well, they're trying to come back from that NCAA loss last year when they were beaten in the NCAA tournament. They had beaten Maryland earlier in the year.
80-72. Lucas will take the three. Won't go. Padilla gets a rebound.
Warm up the bus, baby. This one is history. They got to warm up the bus.
I'll tell you what, Dick, this was a great effort in the second half by Massachusetts. They controlled the game pretty much through the first half, but then foul trouble in the second half, and they were able to gather themselves and hold off that big rush by Maryland. But this was the man that kept his team in today, Joe Smith. But he couldn't do it by himself.
Yeah, Joe Smith was absolutely sensational. He didn't get enough help offensively. I think Gary will be the first guy to sing the praises of Massachusetts in terms of the fact that they showed that character to hang on with the deep foul trouble that they had.
How about Padilla steps up today? 12 points and 7 rebounds.
I'll tell you one thing. You look at playing early, playing Arkansas, Kansas, and playing Maryland, and play them all away from your arena at home, and you can win 2 out of 3 of those clubs. You're a legitimate basketball team.
28 seconds left to go. 81-72. 9 points has been the biggest Massachusetts lead. Remember, Maryland came back to take that 1-point lead, but then UMass came right back.
He was out of bounds. It's right back.
You don't want to foul. Will retain possession.
You don't want to foul right here. You want to play good, hard defense, position defense. Joe Smith, though, showed America he is genuine. He showed it last year. Diaper band to get a year. And Tavares throws it away.
Throws down.
We'll just take it all the way.
A little layup. Good. No showtime. No hot dog in.
That's showing a little maturity.
18 points for Williams. Smith will take the three and miss it as the clock now runs down and the basket put up and in by Johnny Rose.
Nice win. It's going to be John Calipari. He's got a date with Princeton and Western Kentucky. I mean, he's playing a dynamite pre-conference schedule.
Hey, Dick, after Maryland took that 71-70 lead, UMass said, okay, they met the challenge. They've outscored them 13-3 since that time.
Well, you thought that was the time, and I thought as well that Maryland would take command, especially with Rowe out.
Well, you know that possession they came down, and they didn't get it right to Smith, and you were surprised by it?
Exactly.
It just seemed to get them out of whack after that.
I thought it was the time they would really come right down into Joe. Look at Lou Rowe, jubilation, the thrill of victory, as they say.
Norville, he came in and did his part. The young freshman got 4 points in the first half.
Gary will have his team ready. There's no question. They'll regroup. They'll be right in the challenge in the ACC, which there's so much balance. And Joe Smith. You know something else I like about Joe? He said, you know, with all the money now being paid, we got the CBS, that new deal. He said, basically, we deserve a stipend. And I agree with him. I think today's modern-day athlete deserves at least $150 per month. These kids are not allowed to hold a job during the school year.
Oh, it's a great game, Roger. Great game.
85-74. The fifth-ranked Minutemen of UMass beat Maryland. They move their record to 3-1 on the year. 85-74, the final. For Dick Vitale, I'm Roger Twybell. Thanks for being with us. Golf is coming up next.
This has been a presentation of ABC Sports, recognized around the world as the leader in sports television.